Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. I'm Aston. This is Leanne. And today we're watching what?
Dahmer episode 5.
When we started, I really didn't want to watch it. I really was like, I don't want to watch this. And I've come to like it. I don't know if that's a good or a bad thing, but I like the show now and I'm excited to watch it. I'm invested. They got me.
I'm invested too, yeah.
They got me.
What happened in the last one?
This nigga is evil and he will be stopped. And somebody in the comments said that we get to see him get poked up in jail or... I don't even know what it is.
I didn't know that, but...
Yeah. But, I mean, I guess it's a spoiler. I asked, but hey, you guys answered and I appreciate it.
Because we got the best fans. Friends? Subscribers?
Love you guys. And we're about to hop in. We just finished watching House of the Dragon yesterday, and boy, was that thing crazy.
Top tier. Best show. Better.
Not better than Dahmer. For this video, at least, it's not better than Dahmer.
That's when I decided I was going to dig him up.
No freaking way. Bro, get him out of here.
He just wanted to lay with him.
He was still fresh and just,
get this nigga the frick up out of here today.
It was just about if I thought that they were beautiful.
I'm not buying that. You targeted your victims.
Sorry?
You purposefully moved into an apartment in the black community.
That's what I could afford, sir.
To an area that was under-patrolled and underserved. And you knew that, isn't that right? Easier to get away with things there, easier to hunt.
He's more upset than this guy is, because he killed more black people.
And she started to notice the smell.
It's always that smell, bro. I can't even imagine how terrible that smells.
Right.
She didn't want to accept what that meant. That you were... Yeah, I think she just didn't want to know about my,
Are those prescription glasses?
Lifestyle.
They don't look like it.
They don't.
But she noticed the smell.
Yeah. July and August, I kind of dreaded because it got so humid down there. No AC.
Jeff!
You dreaded it?
Something smells real bad down in the cellar.
It's my taxidermy stuff. I told you that already.
He got upset with his grandma, Jeffrey.
But when she found my altar, she kind of blew her top.
His altar?
Oh,
you can't smell that, Jeff. Stuff?
No. Oh. Why are your nana's upset?
Why do I feel like I can smell it?
Ugh. Me too now. That's what it smells like, Dad. Animals and stuff. Taxidermy is my hobby.
Unlock it, Jeff.
Left the key at work, I think.
Jeff, unlock it.
His dad's voice is really cool.
His dad wasn't playing with him. He said, I'm not here for the lies.
It is here. What?
Please don't touch that.
Ooh, back in the day. Had to be back in the day. Oh, he touched it and put it to his face. Ooh. Ooh, I want to fight. What's his dad's name again? Lionel?
I don't remember.
It's one of my experiments. I was just using chemicals to try to melt the flesh and the fur off. I think that one was a skunk.
Oh, you think so, Jeff? You think you could have washed the skunk sludge down the drain a little better?
Jesus.
Don't worry, I'm not a cop.
What? I seen you at the bar. You need some help?
No, I'm all right. Just a dead battery.
I don't know how you're gonna fix that. You should let me help you. I was just... My grandma's house just around the corner. We'd get my car, drive back here, and give you a jump.
Okay, thanks.
Yeah.
I'll just wait here.
Yeah.
Nah, you should come with. This is a rough area. You shouldn't just be like sitting there. Come on, let's grab a taxi before we get robbed.
I'm rolling my window up.
Knocking it.
All right, bro. Well,
thanks a lot.
I literally had the same thought. Like, okay, you go get your car. Yeah.
Gotta be quiet, though. Otherwise, the beast will wake up and start chewing me out.
Would be like, okay, nigga, can we get the whip?
Right.
Frick, I don't care about none of that.
On you already?
I literally don't care about none of that. You don't even have a car.
Yourself at home. Done it quicker than that.
Go get it, or
right,
shut
bro.
Up already.
It's just my friend.
I didn't know you had black friends, Jeff.
Well, it's not the 1920s anymore, whatever, Grandma.
Yes, I know that. What's wrong with them?
Nothing. You just
Grandma, figure it out, Grandma.
I'm just trying to sober him up.
You've been drinking.
No, I haven't.
Get him, Grandma.
He's gotta be sick.
Just go back to bed, Grandma.
You should take that young man to a hospital.
What? He's just a little wasted, Grandma.
I will not have some stranger dying in my house.
He'll be fine. Just let him sleep it off. Jeez.
No. Something is not right here. I'm calling your father.
Hey! Nobody's calling anybody, okay? You got a little too much to drink.
I will go kill Jess right now.
Now go back to bed. What are you doing?
I am giving this young man a blanket. And I am staying down here and watching him until he wakes up.
Thank you,
don't
Grandma.
Have to do that.
And
thank
if
you,
this
Grandma.
Young man is sick, I am taking him to a hospital. Do you understand?
Thank you, Grandma.
Drinking is what you were doing, and God knows what else.
It's fucking unreal!
You watch your mouth, young man. You want to go up to your room, fine, but I am staying right here. And you can bet your sweet baby your father's going to hear about this.
Talk, Grandma.
This guy is drugging people. I went down to the bathhouses. They say they know this guy, Jeff.
He's
blonde. He isn't allowed in anymore on account he's drugging people.
What?
Okay. Like I said, we'll look into it.
Didn't write anything down.
Right.
I'm not asking you to look into it. I'm asking you to go and stop this guy.
I understand. But stuff like this is really hard to prove.
Go to this man's house. Whatever he's using is gonna be there.
You know where his house is?
Yes, I thought I was gonna die in his living room. It's on 57. Between Hayes and Lincoln. I know right where it is.
Well, Jeff, what do you have to say for yourself?
Honestly, I don't know what he's talking about. I met this guy at the bar, and his car needed a jump, and he was really drunk. So I said, you know, come back to my house and try to sober up, have a cup of coffee, and he fell asleep on the chair.
Okay. So you're saying he was just drunk?
Yeah.
And had you been drinking?
I had one beer, but I was fine.
Jeffrey Dahmer.
What? I got a cop asking me what happened, so I'm telling him. I was just trying to do a good thing. I mean, this guy was wasted, trying to drive off in his car. That's illegal, you know.
Hey, if I was to have a look around in your bedroom, I wouldn't find any, you know, like, tranquilizers or whatnot?
No. I don't even know what they would look like, but sure, I mean, it's right upstairs. You want to come take a look?
He's not going to do it.
Mm-mm.
And he said that you stole some money.
What?
And a bracelet?
No, I didn't.
Why is the room, why is their house so much brighter now?
The whole time.
Right.
Grandma, did I look through his wallet?
No. He did not. And I was there the whole time. That is true.
That a bracelet? Jeez. I just don't remember any kind of bracelet.
You gotta be kidding me.
I know it's disappointing. What? But we went to the house. Talked to him, talked to the grandma. You know, it's just, there's two sides to every story.
Jesus.
I mean, he's an odd guy, I'll give you that. Been arrested a couple times, but, and you should know, getting arrested doesn't suddenly make you guilty of everything.
Why should he know that?
I've never been arrested.
Yeah, okay, well, you know.
So let me get this straight.
Oh my goodness.
You gonna take the word of a white guy who's got a criminal record over the word of a black man who doesn't have a criminal record? That's what you're telling me, right? Because I'm telling you that this man tried to kill me. And you're saying there's nothing you can do about that?
Without any evidence, yes. That's what I'm saying.
What was he arrested for?
I can't divulge that information.
Thank you for your time.
That is crazy. That is so crazy. You got my blood boiling. You got my blood boiling.
Hey,
don't get in that cab.
What the hell?
You shut your mouth, motherfucker. Brother, this dude will try and kill you. He's fucking crazy.
Oh, come on. You're just gonna...
Oh my gosh. Yeah, nigga, go home. Goodness gracious, right. Go home.
She's literally a menace. I fear for her.
Same.
This little kid.
Oh my.
That was the brother.
Oh wow.
Luke. I got on my line.
You're going to jail.
Put that on the ground.
You're going to jail. Arrest him! Throw the book at him!
Well, this is what his brother was saying, remember?
Yeah, you tried to take pictures of him and crap.
Yeah.
And it looked like they had like 10 kids. That's probably why he needed the money.
Mm-hmm. Pure evil.
Remind me a lot of my grandson. He had a problem with alcohol, but he turned it around. And now he has a successful car wash. Now, you are not the kind of guy who belongs in the correction system, okay? You need a second chance. And this is your lucky day because I'm going to give it to you. And on the other side of this, hopefully, you will have learned your lesson and you'll get your act together. Now, I see that you have steady employment, so the court is willing to grant you work release of up to 40 hours per week. When you finish your work, you report directly back to jail. And while the court is obliged to inform your employer of this arrangement, I'm willing to do you the favor of leaving out the exact nature of your misconduct.
Oh my goodness.
Does that sound fair to you?
Oh my goodness.
Yes.
No wonder he was able to do so much for so long. This is the same thing those cops said to him. I get all my kids to jump his fucking dad.
Right, embarrassing.
Where are we going?
Grandma's. We're gonna have one last dinner together as a family.
Where's that box?
What box? Don't play dumb. Your grandmother has a box with all my stuff in it.
I like how he
photos,
does.
Photos, ribbons, all my accomplishments.
Oh my god.
And I want you to give it back. Go get it.
I like how his dad doesn't play around with him at all.
No, she gave it to me.
God damn it, Jeff! Get it.
Fine.
And he's following him.
You gonna follow me? Yes, I am.
Jeff, don't lie to me.
I'm not lying to you. I don't know where it is.
Oh,
there's something bad in there, Jeff. What is it? Pornography?
No, it's just like my stuff.
Is it gay pornography, Jeff? Because I'm telling you, all these years I look under your mattress, I don't find a Playboy. And now you're going to jail for molesting a 13-year-old boy.
No, it's just like my stuff, like baseball cards.
You're not going to tell me, are you? Oh, fuck, I'll break the fucking...
Oh, my goodness.
What the heck?
Oh, my goodness. He better open that box up and take... You
take
know
it
what?
Out, right?
Open this fucking door, Jeff!
Don't break your box, Dad. I found the key. Right here.
Punch you in the face. That's what I want to do.
It's just some pornos. Put them in there so Grandma wouldn't find them.
Did I do this to him?
Oh, I mean, I did.
Sweetheart.
I should have stayed in that fucking marriage. I should have done more things with him, like taxidermy. He really loved that stuff.
Honey, you can't do that to yourself.
Because I really should have pushed back harder. I should have pressed him harder to find out what was really going on. You know. But the truth is, he made me uncomfortable. And I really didn't know.
Wow.
All those red flags.
Oh. Hunter, red flags.
And I asked him, you know, every time I asked.
That's a parent's worst nightmare.
Hello? Discharge. What the heck happened, Jeff?
I don't know. I guess they thought I drank too much. They never really said.
So, what? What the heck are you doing with a mannequin, Jeff?
The red flags.
He's replaying everything.
Just did it on a dare. The whole thing was just a joke.
So what were you doing at the State Fair, Jeff? Exposing yourself?
I was just peeing outside. I didn't know anyone could see.
I hate the way he speaks so much. I hate it.
Why did you molest that boy, Jeff?
I didn't molest him. All I did was take some photos.
No bullshit, me.
I'm telling you, I didn't even know how old he was.
Why the kid said you molested him? Why would a kid lie about
it? I don't know why. All I did was take some pictures. I was even gonna pay him. It was all set up. People out to get me, Dad. I don't understand it either.
Who's out to get you?
Right.
The only people out to get you are the people that should be getting you. Because you should be God.
Kid's father. I can't stop seeing the look in his eye. He looked right at me.
Jeff Dahmer. Knew my son was a child. When he met my son, he asked him what grade in school he was in. If my son was not so healthy and athletic, the drug that this man gave my son could have killed him.
Mr. Synthansophoma, I'm sorry, it's just... I am having trouble understanding you. Could one of your children...
Oh, my goodness.
Here? Thank you.
How can you open up the mabatini?
We are immigrants to this country.
I fear not.
We work hard.
We don't
have the money for an expensive lawyer. My family, we're not eating or sleeping.
Okay. Maybe if your father would like to hand his letter to the bailiff, we can enter it into the record.
This episode's making me angry.
Mr. Dahmer, please stand. The charge of sexual assault in the second degree, you have pled no contest. Therefore, I hereby sentence you to 1 year in the custody of the Milwaukee County House of Correction.
Dear Judge Gardner, I believe very strongly that my son, Jeffrey Dahmer, is an alcoholic. If he isn't treated, I have tremendous reservations about Jeff's chances when he hits the street. I've heard of a treatment program that has had great success in treating alcoholics, and that Jeff's placement in such a program is critical to his future. I sincerely hope that you might intervene in some way to help my son, whom I love very much. And for whom I want a better life. I feel this may be our last chance to do something lasting. And that you, Your Honor, might hold that key. Sincerely, Lionel Dahmer.
Lionel, you're right. I hate seeing people do that.
I hate seeing Jeffrey Dahmer.
His dad's probably like, oh my gosh, like, here we go. Like, just stay in there.
Yeah.
Best year of my life.
Hey, you don't like a psychologist, or did you just talk to anybody like a counselor?
About what?
Anything. You know, alcohol for one, or, you know, just how you're, you know, what's going on inside of you. Or maybe, you know, some guidance on how you're meant to be, you know, I gotta, you know, contribute to society. I don't know, just, you know, stuff that I wasn't able to teach you.
No, they just leave you alone in there.
Didn't listen to his letter at all.
I just kept to myself the whole time. That's kind of the best part.
That's not what you needed.
Came out the same person.
Mm-hmm.
Come on, you said we could stop for hamburgers.
Yeah, here. Once you warm up the car, I'm parked down at the very end. I'm gonna hit the John.
Okay.
Oh man, this is hard to watch. Can we skip to the episode where he dies?
You know, it's funny that he said that's all he could afford, but his dad said that he would literally help him wherever he was going to move. So it makes it more, you know what I mean, that he was just targeting
certain people. That was episode something of Dahmer.
5.
And this was the most, this was the worst one, probably. I don't think it was the worst one in like what he did in the episode, more so just seeing how he moves as a person and just seeing his like his motives and how he would talk to people. And like this episode, he really went over the top with how he was complaining,
victimizing himself,
feeling bad for himself, blaming everybody else for his issues, lying about everything,
snapping at other people,
snapping at his mom, his dad, like
his grandma.
I feel like the first four, that was five, the first four, it felt like we were getting used to him. This one, it seemed like we're already used to him, and now he's just
delve into that like serial
and he's
killer.
Just doing too much, and he's always been doing too much, but now it's like I'm just tired of it on the inside, you know,
especially because he said that he felt like he could get away with it, you know, now it was like stronger. And the fact that he was doing everything at his grandmother's house like that, like in the basement, and she was like she was awake during all of that, just hearing everything going on.
Yeah,
that's so uncomfortable to even know that happened.
And sadly, we have the next episode, episode 6, which is everybody saying is the worst episode. So I don't know. I'm not looking forward to it. We're gonna watch it. I said at the beginning I was enjoying the show. I'm still enjoying it, but I'm enjoying it because it's hurting me kind of way.
Yeah, you know? It just grinds your gears. Especially seeing like the courts, the cop, and the judges and everything.
Oh my goodness.
And like his own dad sending a letter like, I need help rehabilitating him because he's not okay. And they just did absolutely nothing that entire year that he was in jail. He was just by himself, which is the main problem, I feel like. So it's just crazy. It's sad.
This crap is draining. Okay, guys. Well, we love you. Thank you for tuning in.
Thank you for 600 subscribers.
Yay. I'd be happier if I wasn't depressed.
Yay.
I'm joking. Not depressed. But thank you guys.
Like, comment, subscribe, and turn on our bell so that you get notified when we post a video.
And we will see you guys next time.
Scling.